So, you want to know how to make an apple pie? Well, step one, head to the Apple Store. After that, it should be pretty self-explanatory. Hey guys, I'm back, TutsByKai, I'm Kai, and today we're back once again taking a look at how to create a mesh or some kind of mesh off of just using vertices, which is super easy, which is really, really useful for a lot of different reasons. So, for instance, if you're making some kind of handle, or you're making some sort of loop, or some sort of thing where you just wanted to go ahead and essentially model the loop or the line or whatever, what have you, using vertices. It's super simple. It's like super, super simple. So what we're gonna do is I'm gonna go ahead and just get rid of everything because I don't need anything in this scene. I'm gonna delete, just drag a box over top of everything, just hit delete on your keyboard, hit shift A, and we're going to search for a thing called in mesh called single vert. Now you won't have this if you don't have something enabled. So let's go ahead. I'm going to go up to preferences, and it's going to open up this box here. And actually you cannot see this box. So I'm actually going to make it so you can see the box right now. I'm going to go ahead and fix it up. There you go. So now you can see we have this, this window right here. And this window is essentially like all the plugins and whatnot. So we have preferences. What we're going to do is I'm going to type in this little search field. We're going to search extra. And then we're gonna make sure extra objects is turned on. So let's go ahead and do, there we go. Extra objects, make sure it's mesh and not curve. You could do curve, but we're gonna leave it on mesh just because I need to explain something. So let's go ahead and make sure that's checked. And then we can go ahead and close this. Now when we hit shift A, that's gonna double up, nice, cool. Now when we hit shift A, you can see that we can go ahead and add single vert right there, boom. And now you can see when we zoom in, you can't really tell what's going on. So before you do anything, before you click anything, go anywhere, hit E to extrude, and you can see that it's creating a second vertice. So what you're doing is you're extruding the one vertice, and it's extruding into two different vertices now. So now when we click and drag this one up here, then we can hit E again to extrude off of this vertice, and then again, E to extrude, E to extrude, E to extrude. We can make this nice little shape like this, you know, something pretty cool, nothing too crazy, you know, whatever. So now hit Tab to go out of edit mode. And you can see now we have this whole line. So these are all the vertices we just made. If you hit G, you can move it around like that. You can see these are all the vertices we just made, which turns into a line. And now let's say you want to go ahead and make this a mesh. Because right now, if you were to render this, you can't see anything. It wouldn't show you anything. The black line is just so we can see like it ourselves. But if you render this, it will not show anything. So the way we add a mesh to this, because it's just a like trail of vertices right now, the way we make this a mesh is we have to go up to Object, and then make sure we scroll on down to Convert, and then make this a curve. Not a mesh, we have to convert this to a curve. Now you can see something will change over here, and it'll add this little tab right here, which says the Object Data Properties. And when we go to Geometry, you can see we can scroll on down to Depth. And when we play with the Depth value and scroll this up, you can see all of a sudden there's a mesh now. Crazy. So now we have a mesh that is just came out of nowhere, essentially. So it's just extruding itself from the vertices. So it took the vertices and then made a mesh around it. So essentially, think of the vertices we made, like all the line, think of that as like the bones, and then this just puts skin on top of the bones, essentially, is what just happened. So we can change the depth size. We can make it really skinny like that, you know, make it super skinny. We can make it super thick. Whoa, looks like intestines. Let's go ahead. And we can turn the resolution up as well. So if we turn the resolution up, you can see it'll add more more vertices on the mesh here, and it'll add more smoothness. But you can see it's still pretty choppy, like here, and then where all the places where we created a new vertice and like extruded them out. So the way we can fix this is if we go to the modifiers tab. So we need to go to modifiers tab here. This little wrench. Hit add modifier and then go to subdivision surface. If we add a subdivision surface modifier, you can see that it'll instantly start smoothing this bad boy out. So you can see, just bump that up to like maybe 3, and then let's go to object and then scroll down to shade smooth. Now you can see if we go ahead and maybe put this on like maybe 4, and then we can go back to the this object data tab and turn the resolution down a little bit. It's a little bit too much resolution on this bad boy. There we go. Nice. So it looks really, really good, as you can see. What now we need to do, I think the last thing that we can do, you see we have a little bit of this chunkiness here still. So we go, make sure that's on. Yeah, there we go. So turn on object shade smooth. There we go. I don't know what I hit, but make sure shade smooth is on so it's not chunky like that. And now you can see it looks really good. So we have this nice tube. You can make literally anything like this. You can literally do any household object. You can make wires like this. Super easy way to make wires. Just make the depth obviously shorter. Super, super easy way to make wires. Look at that. That's literally a wire right there. Boom. Easy. Never seen something easier before in my life. Make wires. You can make drawstrings. You can make I don't even know what else. Literally anything this way. It's so simple. Not even just like wires or clothes or something like that, but like if you need to make like metal like fences, you know, like chain link fences or something. Super, super easy way to do this. But yeah, this is one of the coolest and most versatile tutorials we've ever done, because this is so useful for so many different things. You can make hard shapes, you can make softer shapes, you can make literally anything. So like I said, hope you enjoyed today's tutorial. Hope you learned something new. I will see you in the next one. But yeah, until then, bye bye.